NCLEX practice exam for Neurologic System 1. Question 1. If a male client experienced a cerebrovascular accident CVA that damaged the hypothalamus, the nurse would anticipate that the client has problems with A. Body temperature control, B. Balance and equilibrium, C. Visual acuity, D. Thinking and reasoning. Answer: rather, body's thermostat is located in the hypothalamus, therefore, injury to that area can cause problems of body temperature control. Balance and equilibrium problems are related to cerebellar damage. Visual acuity problems would occur following occipital or optic nerve injury. Thinking and reasoning problems are the result of injury to the cerebellum. Question 2. A female client admitted to an acute care facility after a car accident develops signs and symptoms of increased intracranial pressure ICP. The client is intubated and placed on mechanical ventilation to help reduce ICP. To prevent a further rise in ICP caused by suctioning, the nurse anticipates administering which drug intratracheally before suctioning? A. Phenytoin-dilantin, B. Manitol-O-S-Metrol, C. Lidocaine-Xylocaine, D. Furosemide-Lasix. Answer: C. Administering lidocaine via an intratracheal tube may minimize elevations in ICP caused by suctioning. Although mannitol and furosemide may be given to reduce ICP, they're administered parenterally, not intratracheally. Phenytoin doesn't reduce ICP directly but may be used to abolish seizures, which can increase ICP. However, phenytoin isn't administered intratracheally. Answer: C. The client's history and assessment suggest that he may have increased intracranial pressure ICP. If this is the case, lumbar puncture shouldn't be done because it can quickly decompress the central nervous system and, thereby, cause additional damage. After a head injury, barbiturates may be given to prevent seizures, mechanical ventilation may be required if breathing deteriorates, and elevating the head of the bed may be used to reduce ICP. Question 4. When obtaining the health history from a male client with retinal detachment, the nurse expects the client to report A. Light flashes and floaters in front of the eye, B. A recent driving accident while changing lanes, C. Headaches, nausea, and redness of the eyes, D. Frequent episodes of double vision. Answer: C. Administering lidocaine via an Answer: rather, sudden appearance of light flashes and floaters in front of the affected eye is characteristic of retinal detachment. Difficulty seeing cars in another driving lane suggests gradual loss of peripheral vision, which may indicate glaucoma. Headache, nausea, and redness of the eyes are signs of acute angle closure glaucoma. Double vision is common in clients with cataracts. Question 5. Which nursing diagnosis takes highest priority for a client with Parkinson's crisis? A. Imbalanced nutrition, less than body requirements. B. Ineffective airway clearance. C. Impaired urinary elimination. D. Risk for injury. Answer: B. In Parkinson's crisis, dopamine-related symptoms are severely exacerbated, virtually immobilizing the client. A client confined to bed during such a crisis is at risk for aspiration and pneumonia. Also, excessive drooling increases the risk of airway obstruction. Because of these concerns, the nursing diagnosis of ineffective airway clearance takes highest priority. Although the other options also are appropriate, they aren't immediately life-threatening. Answer C. Administering lidocaine via an endotracheal tube may minimize elevations in ICP caused by suctioning. Although mannitol and furosemide may be given to reduce ICP, they're administered parenterally, not endotracheally. Phenytoin doesn't reduce ICP directly but may be used to abolish seizures, which can increase ICP. However, answer A. The sudden appearance of light flash. Question 5. Which nursing diagnosis takes highest priority for a client with Parkinson's crisis? A. Imbalanced nutrition, less than body requirements. B. Ineffective airway clearance. C. Impaired urinary elimination. Question 1. If a male client experienced a cerebrovascular accident CVA that damaged the hypothalamus, the nurse would anticipate that the client has problems with A. Body temperature control. B. Balance and equilibrium. C. Visual acuity. D. Thinking and reasoning. Answer A. The sudden appearance of light flashes and floaters in front of the affected eye is characteristic of retinal detachment. Difficulty seeing cars in another driving lane suggests gradual loss of peripheral vision, which may indicate glaucoma. Headache, nausea, and redness of the eyes are signs of acute angle closure glaucoma. Double vision is common in clients with cataracts. Question 5. Which nursing diagnosis? Answer B. When used to treat status epilepticus, diazepam may be given every 10 to 15 minutes, as needed, to a maximum dose of 30 mg. The nurse can repeat the regimen in 2 to 4 hours, if necessary, but the total dose shouldn't exceed 100 mg in 24 hours. The nurse must not administer IV diazepam faster than 5 mg/min. Therefore, the dose can't be repeated in 30 to 45 seconds because the first dose wouldn't have been administered completely by that time. Waiting longer than 15 minutes to repeat the dose will increase the client's risk of complications associated with status epilepticus. Question 9. A female client complains of periorbital aching, tearing, blurred vision, and photophobia in her right eye. Ophthalmologic examination reveals a small, irregular, non-reactive pupil, a condition resulting from acute iris inflammation iritis. As part of the client's therapeutic regimen, the physician prescribes atropine sulfate etroposol, 2 drops of 0.5% solution in the right eye twice daily. Atropine sulfate belongs to which drug classification? A. Parasympathetic agent. B. Sympatholytic agent. C. Adrenergic blocker. D. Cholinergic blocker. Question 2. A female client admitted to an acute care facility after a car accident develops signs and symptoms of increased intracranial pressure ICP. The client, answer A. The body's thermostat is located in the hypothalamus, therefore, injury to that area can cause problems of body temperature control. Balance and equilibrium problems are related to cerebellar damage. Visual acuity problems would occur following occipital or optic nerve injury. Thinking and reasoning problems are the result of injury to the cerebrum. Answer B. When used to treat status epileptic. Question 9. A female client complains of periorbital aching, tearing, blurred vision, and photophobia in her right eye. Ophthalmologic examination reveals a small, irregular, non-reactive pupil, a condition resulting from acute iris inflammation iritis. As part of the client's therapeutic regimen, the physician prescribes atropine sulfate etoposole, 2 drops of 0.5% solution in the right. Question 11. An auto mechanic accidentally has battery acid splashed in his eyes. His co-workers irrigate his eyes with water for 20 minutes, and then take him to the emergency department of a nearby hospital, where he receives emergency care for corneal injury. The physician prescribes dexamphazine-maxidex ophthalmic suspension, 2 drops of 0.1% solution to be instilled initially into the conjunctival sacs of both eyes every hour, and polymyxin B sulfate neosporin ophthalmic, 0.5% ointment to be placed in the conjunctival sacs of both eyes every 3 hours. Dexamphazine exerts its therapeutic effect by A. Increasing the exudative reaction of ocular tissue. B. Decreasing leukocyte infiltration at the site of ocular inflammation. C. Inhibiting the action of carbonic anhydrase. D. Producing a meiotic reaction by stimulating and contracting the sphincter muscles of the iris. Answer B. Dexamphazine exerts its therapeutic effect by decreasing leukocyte infiltration at the site of ocular inflammation. This reduces the exudative reaction of diseased tissue, lessening edema, redness, and scarring. Dexamphazine and other anti-inflammatory agents don't inhibit the action of carbonic anhydrase or produce any type of meiotic reaction. Question 1. If a male client experienced a cerebrovascular accident CVA that damaged the hypothalamus, the nurse would anticipate that the client has problems with A. Body temperature control. B. Balance and equilibrium. C. Visual acuity. D. Thinking and reasoning. Question 9. A female client Question 5. Which nursing diagnosis takes highest priority for a client with Parkinson's crisis? A. Imbalanced nutrition, less than body requirements. B. Ineffective airway clearance. C. Impaired urinary elimination. D. Risk for injury. Question 13. After an eye examination, a male client is diagnosed with open-angle glaucoma. The physician prescribes pilocarpine ophthalmic solution Pilocar, 0.25% GTTI, UQID. Based on this prescription, the nurse should teach the client or a family member to administer the drug by A. Instilling 1 drop of pilocarpine 0.25% into both eyes daily. B. Instilling 1 drop of pilocarpine 0.25% into both eyes 4 times daily. C. Instilling 1 drop of pilocarpine 0.25% into the right eye daily. D. Instilling 1 drop of pilocarpine 0.25% into the left eye 4 times daily. Answer B. The abbreviation GTT stands for drop, I is the apothecary's symbol for the number 1, U signifies both eyes, and QID means 4 times a day. Therefore, 1 drop of pilocarpine 0.25% should be instilled into both eyes 4 times daily. Question 5. Which nursing diagnosis takes highest priority for a client with Parkinson's crisis? A. Imbalanced nutrition, less than body requirements. B. Ineffective airway clearance. C. Impaired urinary elimination. D. Risk for injury. Answer A. The sudden appearance of light flashes and floaters in front of the affected eye is characteristic of retinal detachment. Difficulty seeing cars in another driving lane suggests gradual loss of peripheral vision, which may indicate glaucoma. Headache, nausea, and redness of the eyes are signs of acute angle closure glaucoma. Double vision is common in clients with cataracts. Answer B. In Parkinson's crisis, dopamine-related symptoms are severely exacerbated, virtually immobilizing the client. A client confined to bed during such a crisis is at risk for aspiration and pneumonia. Also, excessive drooling increases the risk of airway obstruction. Because of these concerns, the nursing diagnosis of ineffective air. Question 16. A client, age 22, is admitted with bacterial meningitis. Which hospital room would be the best choice for this client? A. A private room down the hall from the nurse's station. B. An isolation room 3 doors from the nurse's station. C. A semi-private room with a 32-year-old client who has viral meningitis. D. A 2-bedroom with a client who previously had bacterial meningitis. Question 5. Which nursing diagnosis? Answer A. The sudden appearance of light flashes and floaters in front of the affected eye is characteristic of retinal detachment. Difficulty seeing cars in another driving lane suggests gradual loss of peripheral vision, which may indicate glaucoma. Headache, nausea, and redness of the eyes are signs of acute angle closure glaucoma. Double vision is common in clients with cataracts. Question 1. If a male client experienced a cerebrovascular accident CVA that damaged the hypothalamus, the nurse would anticipate that the client has problems with A. Body temperature control. B. Balance and equilibrium. C. Visual acuity. D. Thinking and reasoning. Question 11. An automechanic accident. Answer B. When used to treat status epilepticus, diazepam may be given every 10 to 15 minutes, as needed, to a maximum dose of 30 mg. The nurse can repeat the regimen in 2 to 4 hours, if necessary, but the total dose shouldn't exceed 100 mg in 24 hours. The nurse must not administer the body's thermostat is located in the hypothalamus, therefore, injury to that area can cause problems of body temperature control. Balance and equilibrium problems are related to cerebellar damage. Visual acuity problems would occur following occipital or optic nerve injury. Thinking and reasoning problems are the result of injury to the cerebrum. Answer D. For 30 days after a stapedectomy, the client should avoid air travel, sudden movements that may cause trauma, and exposure to loud sounds and pressure changes such as from high altitudes. Immediately after surgery, the client should lie flat with the surgical ear facing upward. Nose blowing is permitted but should be done gently and on one side at a time. The client's first attempt at postoperative ambulation should be supervised to prevent falls caused by vertigo and lightheadedness. The client must avoid shampooing and swimming to keep the dressing and the ear dry. Question 13. After an eye examination, a male client is diagnosed with open-angle glaucoma. The physician prescribes pilocarpine ophthalmic solution Pilocar, 0.25% GTTI, UQID. Based on this prescription, the nurse should teach the client or a family member to administer the drug by answer rather body's thermostat is located in the hypothalamus, therefore, injury to that area can cause problems of body temperature control. Balance and equilibrium problems are related to cerebellar damage. Visual acuity problems would occur following occipital or optic nerve injury. Thinking and reasoning problems are the result of injury to the cerebrum. Question 21. The nurse is monitoring a male client for adverse reactions to atropine sulfate atropine care eye drops. Systemic absorption of atropine sulfate through the conjunctiva can cause which adverse reaction? A. Tachycardia. B. Increased salivation. C. Hypertension. D. Apnea. Question 13. After an eye examination, a male client is diagnosed with open-angle glaucoma. The physician prescribes pilocarpine ophthalmic solution Pilocar, 0.25% GTTI, UQID. Based on this prescription, the nurse should teach the client or a family member to administer the drug by A. Instilling one drop of pilocarpine 0.2. Answer B. Dexamethasone exerts its therapeutic effect by decreasing leukocyte infiltration at the site of ocular inflammation. This reduces the exudative reaction of diseased tissue, lessening edema, redness, and scarring. Dexamethasone and other anti-inflammatory agents don't inhibit the action of carbonic anhydrase or produce any type of meiotic reaction. Answer C. The client's history and assessments. Question 21. The nurse is monitoring a male client for adverse reactions to atropine sulfate atropine care eye drops. Systemic absorption of atropine sulfate through the conjunctiva can cause which adverse reaction? A. Tachycardia. B. Increased salivation. C. Hypertension. Answer rather body's thermostat is located in the hypothalamus, therefore, injury to that area can cause problems of body temperature control. Balance and equilibrium problems are related to cerebellar damage. Visual acuity problems would occur following occipital or optic nerve injury. Thinking and reasoning problems are the result of injury to the cerebrum. Answer B. Dexamphazine exerts its therapeutic effect by decreasing leukocyte infiltration at the site of ocular inflammation. This reduces the exudative reaction of diseased tissue, lessening edema, redness, and scarring. Dexamphazine and other anti-inflammatory agents don't inhibit the action of carbonic anhydrase or produce any type of meiotic reaction. Question 21. The nurse is Answer D. For 30 days after a stapedectomy, the client should avoid air travel, sudden movements that may cause trauma, and exposure to loud sounds and pressure changes such as from high altitudes. Immediately after surgery, the client should lie flat with the surgical ear facing upward. Nose blowing is permitted but should be done gently and on one side at a time. The client's first attempt at postoperative ambulation should be supervised to prevent falls caused by vertigo and lightheadedness. The client must avoid shampooing and swimming to keep the dressing and the ear dry. Answer B. When used to treat status epilepticus, diazepam may be given every 10 to 15 minutes, as needed, to a maximum dose of 30 mg. The nurse can repeat the regimen in 2 to 4 hours, if necessary, but the total dose shouldn't exceed 100 mg in 24 hours. The nurse must not administer IV diazepam faster than 5 mg/minute. Therefore, the dose can't be repeated in 30 to 45 seconds because the first dose wouldn't have been administered completely by that time. Waiting longer than 15 minutes to repeat the dose will increase the client's risk of complications associated with status epilepticus. Question 26. A male client is colorblind. The nurse understands that this client has a problem with A. Rods. B. Cones. C. Lens. D. Aqueous humor. Answer D. For 30 days after a stapedectomy. Question 2. A female client admitted to an acute care facility after a car accident develops signs and symptoms of increased intracranial pressure ICP. The client is intubated and placed on mechanical ventilation to help reduce ICP. To prevent a further rise in ICP caused by suctioning, the nurse anticipates administering which drug intratracheally before suctioning? A. Question 27. A female client who was trapped inside a car for hours after a head-on collision is rushed to the emergency department with multiple injuries. During the neurologic examination, the client responds to painful stimuli with decerebrate posturing. This finding indicates damage to which part of the brain? A. Dencephalon. B. Medulla. C. Midbrain. D. Cortex. Question 28. The nurse is assessing a 37-year-old client diagnosed with multiple sclerosis. Which of the following symptoms would the nurse expect to find? A. Vision changes. B. Absent deep tendon reflexes. C. Tremors at rest. D. Flaccid muscles. Answer D. The headache may be an indication that the aneurysm is leaking. The nurse should notify the physician immediately. Sitting with the client is appropriate, but only after the physician has been notified of the change in the client's condition. The physician will decide whether or not administration of an analgesic is indicated. Informing the nurse manager isn't necessary. Answer B. Dexamethasone exerts its therapeutic effect by decreasing leukocyte